Dear students, Salaam Alaikum. I hope all of you are doing fine. Now today is the second day of classes. This week for your section, this is the first class today on Tuesday, and we shall have the next class on Thursday. Two classes for you this week. Now today we shall start a new way of teaching and learning. I am sure this will be a rich experience for the teachers and for the students. This way of teaching is called long distance teaching or online teaching. We can teach online and you can learn online. There are many advantages. You can do your classes online from the comforts of your homes. As you shall see, it will be a rich experience. Now, in the last 6 weeks, we covered worksheet 1, in which we had factorization, fractions, algebraic expressions, which we covered in the quiz 1. Then after that, we had simple equations. By simple equations, we mean linear equations where you have only x power 1. And the numbers on the left and on the right. Then we had the straight line. Again, the straight line is a linear function. There the power of the variable x is 1 and the remaining are numbers. Then we did the graphs of the straight line, and then we also did the applications of the mathematics we had learned to business problems. In the business problems, again, the equations were linear. We had two equations, one for the supply and one for the demand. Two straight lines, one with positive slope and one with the negative slope. Now today we shall start a new chapter. Chapter 2, which is on non-linear equations. By non-linear, we mean that the power of x is not 1. It is different from 1. What are the numbers different from 1? 1.5, 2, 3, 4. But today we shall focus on power 2. Now, power 2 equations are called quadratic functions. Now, a definition of a quadratic equation. See, a quadratic equation is a second degree equation. Look, the power is 2. That's what we mean by second degree. The general form of a quadratic equation is ax square plus bx plus c equal to 0. There are several things to be noted about this quadratic expression. So we need to have 0 on the right when it is an equation. In its standard form, a cannot be 0, because if a is 0, then this term will go away and we'll be left with a linear term, bx plus c. So a cannot be 0, a can take any real value, b can take any real value, and c can take any real value. A, b, and c are numbers, so we have put them three numbers in three different colors. We have the x square term, the x term, and the number term. Ax square plus bx plus c equal to 0. The number term is like power 0, because x power 0 is 1 provided x is not equal to 0. Now, how do we solve quadratic equations? There are two methods. One is by factorization. We have done a lot of factorization questions in the class. So this part of the class is not going to be new. Now, for example, if we want to solve x square minus 25 equal to 0, then we factorize the thing on the left. And remember, we factorize only when we have 0 on the right. If we have any number other than 0 here, bring it to the left. X square minus 25 equal to 0. And how much is 25? 25 is 5 square. 5 into 5. X square minus 25 equal to x equal to 0, which is x square minus 5 square. So x square minus 25 equal to x square minus 5 square. Now when you have difference of two squares, what do you do? first bracket you put minus, and the second bracket you put plus, x minus 5, x plus 5. Now look at the equation. The factorization part is over on the left. Now we have x square minus 25 equal to 0. It implies that x minus 5 into x plus 5 equal to 0. We should not have anything on the right other than 0. Now we are multiplying two quantities. First bracket and the second bracket equal to 0. Now x minus 5 equal to 0 is, and x plus 5 equal to 0. Why? Because when you multiply two things and get 0, that means one time this is 0, or the second one is 0, or the first one is 0. Let's look at the first one. X minus 5 equal to 0. Take this minus 5 on the right, it becomes plus 5. Your first answer is x equal to 5. Now x plus 5 equal to 0, this plus 5 comes on the right and becomes minus 5. What are the answers? Plus 5 and minus 5. Now we have a pair of answers. In mathematics we say we have a set of answers, capital S. S means set. Now in mathematics we write a set with flower parentheses, flower brackets. See, these are round brackets. We are not going to use round brackets to express the answer. While calculation, we can put round bracket or square bracket or flower bracket. But when we are writing the answers, we have to use only the flower bracket. It means set. Now there are two answers, minus 5 and plus 5. Minus 5 is small, plus 5 is big. You write minus 5, comma, plus 5. See, the order is not very important in this answer, in this slide, in this question. But we have to learn to write small number before the big number. The small number is minus 5. Minus 5 is less than plus 5. We saw the inequalities in worksheet number 1. So we always write the small answer before the big answer. So let me repeat. We have the equation x square minus 25 equal to 0. Now factorize x square minus 25. Put 25 in your calculator under the root. You'll get 5. 25 equal to 5 square. So x square minus 25 equal to x square minus 5 square equal to, when you have square minus square, you put two brackets and you have minus in the first bracket, plus in the second bracket, x minus 5 and x plus 5 equal to 0. Now this is the factorization. Now get back to the equation. X square minus 25 equal to 0 implies x minus 5 into x plus 5 equal to 0. In mathematics, when you multiply two quantities and get 0, that means the first quantity is 0 one time, or the second quantity is 0. So that's why you put or. So one time x is equal to x minus 5 is 0, one time x plus 5 is 0. This is like the equations which we learnt in the first week of the semester. Take this minus 5 on the right, you'll get x equal to 0 plus 5 equal to 5. X plus 5, take this plus 5 on the other side, 0 minus 5 is minus 5. We have two answers, plus 5 and minus 5. 5 is big, minus 5 is small. You put your solution, S means solution, S means set. The set of answers is minus 5 and 5. No need to write and, just write comma and put the flower brackets. Now let's look at another example. Now x square minus 11x plus 24 equal to 0. We have seen this kind of expression before. Where did we see it? When we were factorizing it. Now let's factorize x square minus 11x plus 24. How do you factorize the three terms? This is a three term factorization. How much is 24? 24 is 1 into 24, 2 into 12, 3 into 8, and 4 into 6. But we cannot take any numbers here. We have to take two special numbers. 3 into 8 is 24. Minus 3 minus 8 is minus 11. So we take minus 8 and minus 3. Look, when we multiply this minus 8 into minus 3, minus 8 into minus 3, you'll get plus 24. Minus 8 plus minus 3 is minus 11. So the factorization of x square minus 11x plus 24 is equal to x minus 8, x minus 3, x square minus 11x plus 24 equal to 0 implies x minus 8 into x minus 3 equal to 0. Now we have 0 on the right, and we have two brackets here, two quantities here. So the first quantity is 0, or the second is 0. When the first is 0, x minus 8 equal to 0, take the minus 8 this side, we get 0 plus 8 equal to 8. Take this minus 3 this side, we get 3. So the two answers are 3 and 8. Which is small and which is big? 3 is small, 8 is big, 3 comma 8. So your solution set is 3 comma 8. 3 is the first answer, 8 is the second answer. Now let's look at another example. Now take x square plus 16 equal to 0. This question is similar to the first question. There is no x term here, only the two terms here. Now the solution is x square plus 16 equal to 0. Now you take the plus 16 on the other side, you'll get minus 16. Now you put square root minus 16 in the calculator. What happens? We'll get a math error. There are different types of math error, and this math error, when you take the square root of a negative number, means there is no real solution. There is no real solution. So it is impossible to get a real solution. So we write S equal to empty set. This symbol which you see circle with a straight cross on it, it means it is an empty set. There is no solution. So no solution means the set is empty. You cannot put anything in the flower bracket. So you use this symbol, circle with a cut. So this is a symbol for an empty set. Now let's look at another example. Solve x plus 4 whole square equal to 36. Why do we say whole? Whole means complete. The x plus 4 is inside the bracket and the power is outside. So the solution is, you again factorize. Take this 36 on the left, you'll get x plus 4 whole square minus 36 equal to 0, which is equal to, now we have to factorize this quantity, x plus 4 whole square minus 36. Now this 36 is 6 square. Now a square minus b square is a plus b into a minus b. X plus 4 is like a and 6 is like b. X plus 4 plus 6, x plus 4 minus 6. Now x plus 4 plus 6 is x plus 10 in the first bracket. The second bracket is plus 4 minus 6 is minus 2. You'll get first bracket x plus 10, second bracket x minus 2. Put back in the equation, you'll get x plus 10 into x minus 2 equal to 0. Now same as before, when you multiply two quantities, the first one is 0, then the second one is 0. When the first one is 0, this 10 will come this side, it becomes minus 10, or x minus 2 equal to 0, this minus 2 comes this side and becomes plus 2. So you have again two answers. The big answer is 2, minus 10 is small. Remember the straight line which we had drawn, the number line. The negative numbers are on the left, the positive numbers are on the right. If you look at 0 in the center, and we always write the small number, minus 10 is on the left, 2 is on the right, so minus 10 comma 2. Order is not important, but we have to learn to write the order. Now we have done several examples using factorization. Now let's recall what we have done till now in this class. We have solved quadratic equations. What are quadratic equations? Quadratic equations are ax squared plus bx plus c equal to 0. A is not equal to 0. A, B, and C can take any values with the only condition A is not equal to 0, B and C can take sometimes 0. In some questions, B will be 0, sometimes C will be 0. We'll see examples like that. Now the power is 2, so we are going to get two answers. If this bigger equation with power 3, we'll get 3 answers. If the power is 4, look for 4 answers. But in this semester, in this course, we'll focus on power 2 first, and then worry about other powers. With power 2, you get two answers. Look, this equation, the power was 2, we got two answers, minus 5 and plus 5. Then there was this equation with three terms. Here the factorization requires more practice. We have done many questions on this kind of factorization. Again, we get two answers. Now this is a power 2 equation, and we get a math error when we put minus 16 in the calculator, and then we say there are no real solutions. Actually, there are solutions, but we don't need them in our business purposes. Electrical engineers like this kind of solutions where they get a math error and they know how to manage the math error. For us, whenever we get a math error like this, we'll say that there are no real solutions. We should put the word here, real. And then how do we write the set of solutions? This means the set is empty. There are no real solutions. So we just write the set symbol in this special manner. Now we saw another example where we solved the power 2 equation. There's no need to open this bracket, and we directly solved it. Now, sometimes factorization is not easy. It's not obvious. So what we have to do is there's a formula. Ax square plus bx plus c equal to 0. Always write your quadratic equation like this. Everything on the left and 0 on the right. Everything means there should be three things. X square with a number, red number, x with a blue number, b, and the number alone, which is green in color. Now, the formula is big. First, we calculate this quantity delta. This triangle is called as delta. B square minus 4ac. B square minus 4ac. So this, calculate this delta. B square minus 4ac. Now the B square minus 4ac is a number. Why? A is a number, B is a number, C is a number. When you square a number and then subtract 4ac from it, again you'll be getting some number. Now, what about this number, delta? Now, when you draw the numbered line, you have 0 in the center, positive on the right, and negative on the left. So, how many kinds of numbers you have on the numbered line? The negative number, the 0, and the positive. So if the discriminant, this delta is called discriminant also. It is written here, discriminant here. Now, if the discriminant is equal to 0, you will get only one solution. If the discriminant is less than 0, you will get no real solution. And when the discriminant is more than 1, you'll get two solutions, which are this. So your first answer is minus b minus square root of the discriminant delta. Minus b minus square root of delta full divided by 2a. The second answer is minus b plus square root of delta by 2a. Look, we are going to take the square root of delta here. So just remember, it is the square root of delta here with the minus, and we have the square root of delta with the plus. And the two answers are one with the minus, one with the plus. Now we'll see how to use this formula in a real question. Now we can look at these equations. Now this you can go home and try, and we'll discuss them in the next class. Now just bring this 64 here, this minus 64 will become plus 64, put it in the calculator, you'll get two answers. Bring it to the right, take the root, then you'll have some situation that we'll discuss. Now, what are the factors of 6? 2 and 3. 2 and 3 cannot give you 7. They can give you 5, minus 5, or 1, but 6 into 1, so use 1 into 6 with the suitable signs and factors. This example, question 4, is like the example we had done. Now, question 5, we are going to need the formula which we discussed. And in this question, we should have 0 on the right. So take this 6x this side, take minus 16 this side, and then solve it. We'll discuss it in the next class. Please try these 6 questions. one question, 5 minutes, 3 minutes. 3 minutes, it should not take more than 5 minutes. You can finish this understanding, this test of testing questions in 30 minutes. We'll discuss them in detail in the next class. Now look at this. Solve the quadratic equation using the formula. Please read the English. It says use the formula. Now don't try to factorize this. Now look at this equation. X square plus 2x plus 5 equal to 0. Now we do not write the 1 here, which is written here. A equal to 1, then B equal to 2, and C equal to 5. In mathematics, we don't write plus and 1 unless it is very necessary. To avoid confusion, it is plus 1 here, which is written in red color. You can see it, A equal to 1, B equal to 2, C equal to 5. Now let's calculate the discriminant. B square minus 4AC. We saw the formula of the discriminant. Now B is how much? 2. A is 1. And C is 5. This 4 is part of the formula. Look, the minus 4 is in the formula. Minus 4 is in the formula. 2 square minus 4 into 1 into 5. You get 4. Now 4 into 1 into 5 is 20. 4 minus 20 is minus 16. Now minus 16 is less than 0. So what's the rule? If the discriminant is less than 0, the equation has no solution, and we write no solution means no real solution. It means the set is empty. Now let's look at another equation. Solve the equation using the formula. What equation? Quadratic equation. 4x square minus 3x minus 10 equal to 0. Now the number before x square is a. So a equal to 4. The number before x is b. How much is b? Plus 3 or minus 3? We have to take the full number. So b is minus 3. Do not forget the minus. C is this full number minus 10. The full number is minus 10, C equal to minus 10. Step 2, compute the discriminant. Delta equal to B square minus 4AC. Please memorize this formula. Now delta is minus 3 whole square. Look, B is minus 3. So put minus 3 in the bracket, square it. Square of a negative number is positive. So minus 3 whole square is minus 3 into minus 3 equal to 9. Now, minus 4AC. This minus 4 is in the formula. A equal to 4, C equal to minus 10. Now before you touch your calculators, decide whether it is negative or positive. Minus into minus is plus. So you get plus here. 4 into 4 is 16. 16 into 10 is 160. It is called 160. 160. 9 plus 160. We have 9 plus 160 equal to 169. Now before doing anything else, decide, inspect. 169 is more than 0, it is positive. So we are going to get two solutions, two real solutions, and both will be unequal because this number is not 0. If it is 0, you get one answer. If it is not zero, more than 0, you get two answers. Case 2. Now x1 is minus b minus square root. Do not forget the square root. Square root of 169, put in the calculator, you will get 13. The first answer is minus b. Now minus b. B is how much? Minus 3. Minus into minus is plus 3. So 3 minus 13 divided by 2a. A is how much? 4. 4 in 2 into 4? 8. 3 minus 13 by 8. You get minus 10 by 8. Minus 5 by 4. If you want, you can write it as also in your calculator as minus 1.25. And the second answer, look, the first answer is minus, the second answer is plus. Now again put it, only this minus 13 will become plus 13. 3 plus 13 is 16. 16 by 8 is 2. Now you have two answers, minus 5 by 4 and 2. This is small, this is big. 2 is big, minus 5 by 4 is small. Put the small first, then the comma, then the second answer. Let's look at the next example. Now solve the quadratic equation using the formula. X square plus 6x plus 9 equal to 0. Now how much is a? A is here. What's the number here? 1. It is plus 1. We never write it. Nothing means 1 in this case. B is 6. C is 9. Now a is 1. B is 6. C is 9. Calculate the discriminant. The delta. This triangle which you see, b square minus 4ac, b is 6, 6 square, 36. Minus 4, a is 1 and this 9. 4 into 1 into 9 is 36. Remember the minus, 36 minus 36 is 0. So this is the step 3 of the solution. Now the discriminant is 0. That means we'll get only one answer, which is x equal to minus b by 2a minus 6 divided by 2 into 1, 2. 6 divided by 2 is 3, and remember the minus, you get minus 6 divided by 2 as minus 3. So your set of answers is, S means the set of solutions, capital S equal to minus 3. Now you have to test your understanding by solving these 6 equations after going home. We'll discuss it in the next week. Now again, this will not take more than 5 minutes for one answer. Some will take 2 minutes, some will take 3 minutes. Use the formula, and after you have finished with the formula, also try to factorize. If you can factorize this, it is always good to do the answer in more than one way. Now, first, second, third, fourth is straightforward. Fifth is also straightforward. A is 3, B is minus 18, C is 29. Some of us will need calculators for this kind of numbers. Use the calculators carefully. Remember, there is a minus here. Now in your third equation, this 6x has to go on the left and this minus 16 has to go on the left, and then you should have 0 on the right. In the first 5 equations, 0 is on the right. Take these two things to the left and solve it. We'll discuss it in the next class. Now so much for today. So today what we did was we learned to solve the quadratic equations. They are not difficult. They can be solved by factorization and they can be solved by the formula. These quadratic equations will come in your business questions, in your graph questions, and in some other chapters. So please learn these quadratic equations. Your first worksheet was all about linear equations. Now your second worksheet is all about your quadratic equations. Go through it carefully, understand it. Inshallah, we'll continue next time. Please study this. Please go through the worksheet which I have uploaded. It has solved examples similar to the ones here. Solve them, compare with this. That will give you some idea. And please solve this. And I'm available round the clock. You just send me an email. I keep checking it early in the morning, late in the night, in the afternoon and in the evening, and I'll answer. And I'll definitely be inshallah available during your class hours on Sunday, Tuesday and Thursday, 11 to 12. So that's your prime time. Catch me there, and you can also find me at other times. Thank you. Assalamu alaikum.